Bitches, what's up, Bobo Savage, coming at you live, and I'm doing a response video to Esoteric. As you can tell by the title, this is his response to the video titled, the title is extremely loose, Top 3 Lies About Buck Bitcoin and Cryptocurrency Debunked. Oh. This is the Esoteric Crypto Cult Cringe Fest. Let's get this shit on. Anyway, let's get on with it.
I got offered at the time like $5 million worth of Bitcoin. I think it was like $38 million by the time it got there. I refused it. And I got told like 8 years ago, I got told by two different people. Very well-known rich people. They said, George Soros likes you. He wants to work with you. And Alexander Soros and this other Soros. You just need to stop attacking. And by the way, we want you to pump Bitcoin, which I believe in cryptocurrencies. I believe it's the future. We have a private Federal Reserve. It's all fiat. I'm not judging anybody. I'm just saying, be careful. And I was so dumb back then. I don't even say so dumb. I was not in the corrupt mindset the way the world worked. Like, I knew how politics worked, and I knew how science worked, and I knew how crypto type.
No, you are not hearing things. On Joe Rogan's recent podcast he did with Alex Jones as his guest.
I'm kind of retarded.
Alex.
Right there. No fucking shit. I gotta hand it to him.
And ironically attempted to claim that cryptocurrency is a pawn of George Soros and government shills by suggesting, without evidence in his usual fashion, that they're trying to pay people to show it. To what ends exactly? Well, he doesn't explain, showing that the premise is just as well thought out as the buffoonish claim is in the first place.
Okay. Essa, that was just it's deliciously hilarious. That little clip you just timed so perfectly. That was beautiful. Absolutely the best thing about this entire video. I love it, as you can tell. As my audience can fucking tell. Oh, I lost my shit. Fuckers like that didn't make me feel sane, and I'm fucking batshit nuts. But I try to be factual, too. But without further ado, let's get in the shitstorm, shall we? Well, first off, it's not what he claimed. He claimed four things, actually. This is a strongman argument already. So, we've already encountered a Essa, you can't even quote somebody directly. What? whatever. What we got here, what he said was he was offered billions in Bitcoin, turned it down. Two rich people supposedly told him, supposedly, and I use that term with emphasis on it, supposedly, that two well-known, extremely rich people talked to him and said, "Hey, George Soros likes you, wants to work with you if you would just leave him, if you would just leave him the hell alone." And then the other, third claim is, "Hey, we want you to pump up Bitcoin." And then he said, the fourth claim is, "Everyone just be careful about Bitcoin." Now, I know where S was getting the straw man from. It's still a straw man regardless, because if you just look at that, that's all he says, actually, and I just listened to it. Now, the reason he made the straw man is because he added the context of Alex Jones' history of being anti-crypto, but honestly, that's one of the smart things he's ever promoted. But, it's still a straw man. And the fact that being anti-crypto is buffoonish, like what? Like the shit you're about to say? Come on, SO. You got a history of contradicting yourself and making, "Ah, I'm tossing the best salad." That was intentionally cringy. That was intentionally done that way. I say this is, but anyways, let's get on with it.
Then, in his typical manner, when spreading a narrative like this that just happens to be in the mainstream media's talking point list and in the state's interests.
Not really. Mainstream media is promoting it in one hand, and on the other is against it. Why? I don't know. The state, that's the corporate media conglomerates, there's like 30 of them, Fox News and other so-called right-wingers, plebeian panderers. They're all a bunch of mega corporation media conglomerates. They're gonna tell, some of them tell more truths than others, and the biases will still show up regardless. They have their biases that, you know. But let's continue.
But would piss off a lot of his viewers if he were to take this position as a hard line.
Yeah, because a lot of his fans are like you, a crypto cultist. I get it.
And just generally doesn't have any proof and could easily be called out for not having any, using mental gymnastics, which would give you whiplash if you're not prepared for.
The mental gymnastics part, you have no fucking room to talk, because you got a massive fucking history doing that, SO. You got a massive history of that shit in your own channel. Now, I like some of your video content. You do have genuinely decent video content here and there. I'm not gonna lie. I can't concede to that. But you tossed the best salad, so I did the nipple rub cringe bit about you tossing the best salad, because you do mental gymnastics and word salad tossing like no tomorrow. You have no room to talk about anyone else doing it. You have no room to talk. Another thing, I'll concede with you on the fact that he does not show evidence a chunk of the time about some of his shit. Now, when it comes to the pro-Trump stuff, all you got to do is go look up QAnon. Whoever QAnon is pisses Trump off. That's also something you need to factor in. Because, yeah.
He then pretends he's still in favor of whatever he just claimed was a tool of the political elite by taking on this bullshit, fake, self-contradicting, passive attitude where he just doesn't know, man, but makes this claim anyway so that the soundbite, and therefore the idea, gets out there and supplants itself into the anti-establishment circles InfoWars attempts to pander to. Well, unfortunately for Alex, he has a consistent track record of spreading anti-crypto propaganda through InfoWars.
Crypto, it's being against cryptocurrency when you learn the truth about it, is not propaganda. That's what you're doing. Trying to rebuttal something that's factual. That would be on your end, SO.
like when he hosted Peter Cryptocurrency is a Ponzi Scheme Schiff on this program. And
it's technically a Ponzi scheme when suddenly there's statistics showing that 1,000 accounts, only 1,000 out of the billions of motherfuckers with accounts on the fucking planet, have 85% of all the Bitcoin, and it's not that very, it's not that, that makes it a Ponzi scheme in practice, son. Please remember that, because that, in theory and practice, that's what makes it into a Ponzi scheme. The fact that that happens. Links are going to be in description.
Had him attempt to argue pretty much every quasi-intellectual, nonsensical talking point about cryptocurrency that the mainstream media has been propagating for the last 3 years or so.
Currencies, and we're looking for an alternative, and, you know, I just don't believe that these cryptocurrencies ultimately can be money.
They can't be money. Not really. You just use them temporarily, but it's not really sound money. This is... Yeah.
So this facade which Alex uses to try and pretend he isn't a snake in the grass falls apart very quickly. Now, I have a lot more to say about Alex because I've been doing a lot of research on him and
I'll concede to that!
Because I've been noticing quite a few reoccurring anomalies in his broadcasts in terms of narrative, logical consistency, and how he treats his guests. And I have ended up finding a lot of dirt which no one else otherwise would have known about.
Whatever you found out, I guarantee whoever these people or single person in the state, QAnon as they're called, through 8chan, postings they put up, you got to keep a lookout for because you'll get red-pilled about a lot of shit through them. You got to factor them in too, dude.
But that's not the subject of today's video. So, I'll have to save it. All I'll say for the time being, Alex, is that I know about your COINTELPRO connections. The reason I mention this interview is that it's the summation of a relatively concerning recent phenomenon I've been noticing, in which figures or media outlets which report on the news and attempts to paint themselves as alternative media, being separate from the mainstream media, have been spreading counter-narratives about cryptocurrency, which suggest that cryptocurrency is some sort of plot by the government or financial scam.
Well, I've already said it was a it turns into a financial scam when the fucking majority of it's monopolized by 1,000 account owners, statistically shown. And then there's a few other things where why and the it's like imagine fiat money, which is based on blind faith but through a digital network, and it kind of is more super volatile than fiat. But anyways, so you've shown screen caps of commenters trying to reason with you instead of actually citing sources of who the fuck were these mainstream media outlets claiming to be alt media.
For those who are unaware, I explain this in greater detail here. The link will be located in the description. Since the first cryptocurrency, Bitcoin, was developed in late 2008, governments of the world have been freaking out about it. Why? Well, because cryptography-based ledgers and blockchain systems can't be monitored by the state.
Except the IRS has been doing it since 2015, coincidentally, hackers figured out how to track it, and it's all in the wild, worldwide web. But yeah. No. The state can have actually good actors in it that know how to do good acting. A lot of the time they don't, but this is one of the few times they do. Nice try, dude.
And in the case of cryptocurrency specifically, the value of the currency is intrinsically based on its supply and demand, and since the coin won't...
Whoa. Please, do not use such stupid word sounds. Please don't. And I'm being polite here, not using emotional reeing. I'm just saying, please don't, because, first off, you can't use a law of economics to intrinsically back something, because the laws of economics, let alone Say's law, which you just used, which is what supply side economics follows. And post-Keynesians try to deny it using minority statistics that don't really conflict it, but they claim it does. And that's a whole fucking mess of bullshit. That's the one I've read into it. But the point is, like, the laws of physics, that, you know, like, and the essential fields that manifest essential particles that make matter as we know it, thanks to Higgs and others, and how they churn the fields up, or if you're one of the, alternative, science dissidence theorists, with a modern interpretation of the ether theory that factors in the stuff that Einstein took from others and put together with mathematical wizardry on a chalkboard and call it relativity, when these were relativistic theories used to try to remedy the ether theory to factor into Michelson-Morley's lack of ether drift results in the experiments. That's a whole other fucking story to tell. Holy shit. That's a mind fucking half, but... Or if you're a conventional mainstream physicist, you know, you're churning up the fields, or in their cases, these science dissidents, churning up the ether to excite the different particle fields, if you're one of them guys. Yeah, they exist, and they actually have physics books, and, you know, et cetera, et cetera. They have books trying to show their case on this. Not looked into enough. I mean, you have to decide for yourself when you find them. Some of them are absolutely fail in factoring, you know, shit like black holes and all that shit, you know, that really exists. So, you know, there's a lot of fails on there, a lot of them, but you get my point. Well, another thing. Back to this initial. The essential particle fields that excite, like the electron field shoots out, makes electrons and it's excited. Muon field, proton field, photon field, blah, 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 blah. The four elemental forces in nature, gravity, electromagnetic, strong nuclear force, and weak nuclear force. They, and the laws of physics, they have to be interacted with, or they have to be, well, in the field's case, they have to be the fundamental forces in nature have to be, how do you put it? That you can't use them to use as a form of intrinsic value backing, because these laws and strong theories and science and economics have to manifest in the right moment, the right environment, and situations for them to exert influence in a way that can be noticed or detected and examined and calculated. Based on that, you cannot use a law of whatever the fuck or strong theory as something to intrinsically back something. That's why this is word salad. It took me along, so I'll give you an example. This fork has intrinsic properties to it. Now, this does not have enough of a scarcity to it, because I would think quite a few of these motherfuckers are made. Quite a few of these sons of bitches are made. Way too common. It would hyperinflate just trying to do it. But it's a commodity. It's a very useful commodity. We eat it. Some of us want to be perverted at the dinner table and go, I know, I just raped a fork, I know. But that has useful properties to us. It has intrinsic properties to it, but in a objective manner. And that allows... Those are the things that give it both a commodity and an intrinsic values. But through those means. And then once you put that into gold and silver, those values have gone up because of what we found out, what we can do with them in an intrinsic, you know, objective angle. So that can be used to, because it's a useful commodity for us, so it's through the sciences and shit, the hard knowledge. And we use that. And through that consequence, I hope I said this right. Correct me if I'm wrong, anyone out there that's listening. But it's a material good, it has intrinsic properties, and it's a useful commodity. So that's how, through those results, that's what intrinsic backing and commodity backing tie together and pretty much are two reasonings for the same system. You cannot use a law that has to manifest in the right environment, right situation, and et cetera, like I've already said. That's why this is a word salad. Holy shit.
wallets are encrypted, along with the fact that anyone can set up a mining operation on their computer and mine more of the currency into existence, and is directly incentivized to do so by the profit they receive from mining, cryptocurrency does not require banking or payment processors, so there's no middleman you'd have to go through in order to engage in financial transactions.
I'm going to call absolute horseshit on this. The fact that every transaction you could find gets retro-converted back into fiat, so the government tracks your ass by default through that. That is a backdoor. If you can convert something to fiat money, that fiat money, with the transaction, the feds will detect it because the Fed Reserve makes fiat money. Hey, guess what? It can be traced to that one alone. Even without looking at the Bitcoin tracking since 2015. It was fucked from the start. I'm going to do a part two of this, folks, because I'm not going to go into 30 fucking minutes, 69 seconds. There's so much nope in this video, it's going to take me a couple more. It might take me two or three more. Just to respond to each and every one of these, because so much juggled shit in it. You ever heard somebody whose heart's in the right place, but their facts are wrong, or really just not facts, but they consider them facts? You ever heard that? That's what I want to say about this guy here. I'm going to delve into this more in episode 2. Little correction on one of the previous arguments in part 1. When I said pisses Trump off, I meant pisses Alex Jones off. So whoever QAnon is deliberately knows Alex Jones and pisses Jones off. That's what I meant to say. Sorry about that mistake. Gonna post it at the end of the video just for correction. Mwah. I'll see you later.